In previous tutorial, we show you how to create a nebula particles effect using 3.js. This tutorial is still space related. Today, we are going to show you how to create a space warp background effect using JavaScript and 3.js in just a few minutes. Let's check it out. Here is the basic CSS for this page. Just reset the margin to 0 and overflow hidden to remove the scroll bar. Now let's import 3.js library to our page. Then start with the basic setup. We will need to create scene, camera, and renderer. First, create a new scene object. Then set up a perspective camera with 60 degrees viewing angle. And 1000 viewing frustum. I will place the camera and rotate it 90 degrees upward into the sky. We'll come back and create the falling stars particle later. And next we'll set up the WebGL renderer. We will set the size to match the current viewport. Then append it to the page as canvas element. Finally, create a rendering loop by creating a function to render our scene. Then use request animation frame to recursively call itself. The basic setup is complete. It's still an empty page, but if you open the console, you will see 3.js message that indicates everything is running fine and good to go. Next, we'll create star particles. Since we are going to need thousands of them, creating a sphere shape for each particle is very expensive and make our website slow. Instead, we'll create a single 3D object with lots of vertices. Then for each of the vertex on that object, we will map it with a circle texture. In 3.js, we call this a points object, which is very useful for dealing with particles. Now let's start with creating the geometry. Then we'll create a loop to add each vertex or star. For this tutorial, 6000 should be enough. Then we'll random the position and add it to the vertices array. And next, start mapping texture. You can use any white circle with transparent background, like this one. Then use texture loader to load the image. And create a points material. Set the color to white. Adjust the size and map it with the loaded image. Now geometry and material are ready. We'll create a points object and add it to the scene. Looks good. Now let's animate it. First, we'll set the initial velocity for each star to 0, with small acceleration. Then on each animation frame, we'll loop through each vertex and update the velocity. Then move the stars along the y-axis with velocity amount. Then if the stars falls behind the screen, we will reset its position and velocity to start over again. Then we will tell 3.js to update our new vertices position by setting vertices need update to true. Finally, I will add a small rotation to all stars to create a little cinematic effect. And the effect is ready. After adding some additional code and CSS, now we can have a simple website with our scene as background. So that's all for this video, hope you guys enjoy. If you like this, don't forget to subscribe to stay tuned for more dev tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching, see you next time, bye!